vaccination and immunization. So vaccination is that meaning, the vaccination is the process of to development of immune system against the particular disease that is by inoculated by the weakened pathogen antigen toxins to the healthy person. So again I explain vaccination. So vaccination is the process to development of immune system against the particular disease, so that is inoculated by the weakened pathogen toxins to the healthy person. Okay, right. So here the vaccination is the process that is mostly based on the memory of immune system. Right. So next, the immunization. Okay, immunization, so it is the development of, it is processed due to the formation of memory B cells by the immune system. Okay, so when the pathogen enters the body, so then it invade on them. So after, the immune system they can avoid and they can destroy the pathogens. Okay, so for example, here the hepatitis B is the vaccine that is produced by the immunized yeast cells. Okay, so the hepatitis B is the vaccine that is produced by the modified yeast. Okay, so the next one, immunological disorders. Okay, so at any situation the result of any impairment referred as the immunological disorders. So the impairment of results, so that indicates the immunological disorders are indicates four types. So that one here, immunodeficiency disorders. Next, hypersensitivity. And third one is autoimmune disorders. And fourth one is graft rejection. Let's see that immunological disorders. So first one is the immunodeficiency disorders. So here the immunodeficiency is caused by the one or more components or defect in the acquired and innate immunity. So here the immunodeficiency disorders are caused by the defect of one or more components in the acquired and innate immunity. Okay, so these immunodeficiency disorders are in two types. First one is primary immuno immuno deficiency disorders. Second one is secondary immunodeficiency disorder. Okay, so here the primary immunodeficiency disorder causes due to the genetical defects. It is from inherited. So for example, here SCID, severe combined immunodeficiency. Okay, so next, secondary immunodeficiency disorder. So this immunodeficiency disorder causes due to the aging and as well as infections. Okay, so here the example is AIDS is the disease. So let's see the AIDS disease. So now we are going to discuss about the disease of AIDS. Okay, right, AIDS. So the full form of AIDS acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. Acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So here it is non-congenital disease. It is lethal, and next it is transmissible, and so mostly it is the STD. That means here sexually transmitted diseases. Okay, so right, so these AIDS disease is caused by the HIV. So here HIV means human immunodeficiency disorder or virus. Okay, so AIDS, that full form of AIDS is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. So the points of AIDS is, it is non-congenital disease. So it is the lethal disease. It is transmissible. So it gets chance to the transmissible. So, and it is the STD. STD means here sexually transmitted disease. And so the main causes for the AIDS disease is virus, that human immunodeficiency virus. Okay, so generally this AIDS disease in worldwide, the firstly discovered in the year of 1981 at the America. Okay, so by the help of Center for Disease Control. Okay, so next, transmission of this AIDS or HIV virus. Transmission. So here the HIV virus transmitted through the sexually affected person. Next, okay, so the virus enters through the blood, contaminated blood. and so the virus get enters through the chance to the using and sharing and using the unsterilized syringes and needles and generally the HIV or AIDS transmitted through the parents or mother to child through the placenta. So these are the chances to transmission of AIDS or HIV virus get into the body. So the most important point is that there is no entering into the body by the physical contact like touching, right? Next is your structure of HIV virus structure. Okay, so it is retrovirus. It envelopes two ssRNA means here single stranded RNA, and it consists the two molecules of reverse transcriptase enzyme. So the HIV virus, it is a retrovirus. So it consists two strands of RNA, that is the single strands of RNA. It is enclosed by the two ssRNA, single stranded RNA, and it consists of the genetical material. Okay, so and it has the two molecules of reverse transcriptase. So these envelope is framed by the protein coat. So this protein coat is surrounded by the lipid layer. Okay, so the lipid layer consists of the glycoproteins, like here 41 glycoprotein GP. So the lipid layer consists two glycoproteins, that is 41 and 120 glycoprotein. So these glycoproteins are combined with the host cell surface receptors. Okay, so it is the structure of HIV virus. It has the two single stranded RNA with the genetical material, and it has the two molecules of reverse transcriptase enzyme. So these envelope is enclosed by the protein coat, and these protein coat are surrounded by the lipid layer. So every lipid layer constitute the glycoproteins. In this lipid layer consists the 41 glycoprotein and 120 glycoprotein. So these during the infections, the glycoproteins are attached to the host cells with the help of surface receptors. Okay, next, replication of HIV virus. So here the HIV virus mostly affects on the areas of phagocytes
and TH cells, TH cells. Okay, so right here, and macrophages. Okay, so which constitute high CD4 markers, CD4 markers, right? So yeah, in the replication of HIV virus, so that high mostly affects on the phagocytes, TH cells and macrophages, phages, which high CD4 markers. So here the two single stranded RNA is released by the HIV virus into the host cell, into the host cell. Okay, so it binds with the CD4 markers, binds with CD4 markers. Here the single stranded RNA that is released by the HIV virus into the host cells, that combines with the CD4 markers.